Hi everyone, this is a demo on the IBM Data Cap and IBM Case Manager. This is the software used for this demo, Data Cap version 9.01 FP2, FileNet CP 5.21, FixPack 5, Navigator 2.03. FixPack 7 and FileNet Case Manager 5.3.0. So I will show you here how to take the input from the data cap and after that create a case in the case manager and process the cases. So it is divided into different part. First part I will cover create application in data cap, then create fields, then create rules, the different type of rules which is required for this demo I will show you here, and after that adding rules to TCO. And next part I will show you regarding in the Navigator, this is how to configure repository in Navigator for data cap and how to configure the desktop for the Navigator in Navigator for the data cap, and after how to configuration on Navigator task within data cap administrator. Then part 3, how to configure mobile in data cap and how to capture data from the from mobile, and what we need to change to the workflow for the mobile and give the access to the all tasks like shortcuts in part 3. Then in part 4 related to the case manager, here I will show you case builder and create a solution, creating fields and role in builder, creating documents, creating tasks, creating workflow and deploy the solution. This solution will be used for the where the input is coming from the data cap. In part 5 we'll show you creating security profile to case manager using admin profile, process the cases in the case manager, then 3 level of hierarchy here, executive manager and finance manager, how cases are moving between from executive to manager to finance manager. Now I am logging to the data cap server. Now here I will open the Data Cap Studio. This is a demo already created here, but I will show you how to create a new demo here. I am closing it. Just creating a data cap widget here. Now next. Now create a new RSS application. Then give the application name is here, final demo, and use the template here, select a template from template. Actually final demo is already there, so it is showing red color here, already exists, you can see. So I am giving different name. Now here we can create a document hierarchy. We will create it later, and we can add here sample image. So we can add here, I will, but in this demo I will add it, add it later. Now finish it and it will create the application. So it is already created, so I am just instead of FinSim cancelling it, and I will open application from here, final demo. It is user ID is admin and password is also admin. Now here you can see here there are two type. This first level is showing the documents. So if you want to create a document, you can go here and add a something issue is there, it is hanging. 1 minute. Okay, first if you want to add anything here, the first we need to lock it. Now you can see here add document, you can add document, you can add pages, you can add fields. So first this is the first level, it is a document. So I've created here two documents, hotel bill and electricity bill. Now when I will open this hotel bill, it is showing the pages, and we can add the pages like this, new pages. So I've given pages name is hotel invoices, and under this invoices there are five fields are there: hotel name, arriving date, departing date, room rate and total rate. This is a field name. We can add this field like this, multiple fields. Give the entry here 1, 2, 3, 4, it will create the new fields. Similarly, I will create it earlier. This is the electricity bill is a document, and under this this is the electricity invoice is the page, and under this is a lots of fields. Around 15 fields are there. So here we can create this template, we can create this fields based on the input template available here. So I will show you template here. This is the hotel bill, you can see here. This hotel template is containing the hotel name, arriving date, departing date, room rate, total amount. So we can create n numbers of field according to the template. And second one is electricity bill. Now you can see that there are multiple fields are there, like name, address, circle, division, subdivision, account number, bill number, bill date. So here I've captured 15 fields from this template. This is electricity bill. See, this is the address, is you can see here Bharti Cellular Limited, Trapti Complex, Gorakhpur. So based on these two templates, we need to define the DCO, and we have to define the DCO over here, document hierarchy field. Here based on this we can define document class, document, then pages, then under paid pages we need to define the fields. This is a hierarchy here, so I have defined here, and later on we will map those fields to the template. I will show you later. Now this is is created. Now next step is we need to create the template. Now here you can see here, this is a fingerprints we need to create. So I've created here fingerprints for hotel bill and electricity bill. So what we need to do, you can see here dropped in here two drop downs here, add fingerprint classes and add fingerprints. So first we need to create a fingerprint classes to distinguish the two, electricity bill and hotel bill. You can create, give the custom class name, anything, electricity classes or hotel classes, anything you want, you can give the name. So after creating the fingerprint classes, you can just go here and create 8 fingerprints. When you will click on 8 fingerprint, it will open this window and you can select the template whatever you want to create the fingerprint from that. So you can, when you will select this document, so it is showing, this is next number is 563, is showing others, these templates are there. So it is other showing, it is not defined any pages here, so we need to define this page, electricity invoice or hotel invoice. So earlier we have created two pages, so it is showing here two pages. So it is electricity invoice, so I will select here from electricity invoice. And we need to map though all the fields, you can see here in the document. So for time being, I am just removing it because I've already created here, you can see here, and it will show here the zones. So just check it out here, it is showing the names. I have just selected and highlighted these things. Customer address showing this thing. Corresponding to each field, we need to create a zone for this. You can see the different zones are showing in this template. We can select two fields or multiple n number of fields based on the requirement. So in this field, I have selected 15 fields over here. You can see. Similarly, I have done same for the hotel class, and when I will select the hotel invoice, hotel fingerprints, so I have taken this one hotel invoice page and invoice field to the hotel fingerprints. We need to zoning it. You can see here, it is a less field, it is showing clearly. See, it is nothing but we can just go and select like this, it moved here. Again, I want to create here this one, you can see out, right? So after doing this, you have to save it and unlock it. So it will saved your changes here. So I am unlocking it. Now it is saved, zone is saved here. You can see the details here. Default position is showing here, and this fingerprint, it is showing the position also here. Similarly, you can check it out here. Please check this position corresponding to the fingerprint number. This is position 557, it is showing fingerprint number here, and it is showing here. And you can see that it is showing some blue color inside this box. It means it is defined perfectly. If you are not able to see this position number and this is it is not showing any color over in this field, so it means something is wrong. Now we have defined the DCO, means document, pages and fields, and we have defined fingerprints. Now we need to define the rules. So I will come here to defining these rules here. So, this is the recognized page and fields is default for this version of 9.0.1. So when you will select this hotel name and you will select this one, this recognize pages and fill, just click on this setting here. You can select by right click or you can click on here setting. So just you want to enable this read field and add page recognition text to the zone. This means it will recognize that field from the images because we have already created the zones. So just save and close it and repeat the same thing for all the fields. Like select the fields here DCO, then select this rule set and click on the settings, enable the read field and enable this 8 page recognition text to zone. After doing for all fields as well as doing the same with the electricity bill, this is customer name here, just select here and setting, click on the checkbox and click on this radio button. This is for the OCR. Now after when we will do it, after that we can see it will create all the fields details here. Like I will show you the one example here. This is the customer name. You can see it will create this field automatically, and it will see this field is snap CCO to DCO. This is automatically it will come, no need to do anything. Like all the fields, we need to do same thing for the pages also. Like select this page and select this one and setting read field, select the checkbox read field, load zone for field, read machine print and run OCR recognition. When you will save and close it, it will show like this here. This is two things for the pages. So repeat the same thing for the hotel invoice and the electricity invoice. This two things for the pages and do the same for the all the fields available here. So it will create the same thing over here. This two things for the pages and rest of the things for the created for the all the field individual fields. So it is required, it means it will read the data from the particular zone which we have already captured in the fingerprint while creating the fingerprint. This is the one rule set we need to do it. And after that we need to export the rule set, all the export into XML, or we can export into the FileNet. So we need to create two rule set over here. This is export to XML. This is creating the rule set. How to create the rule set? Just select on this one and create a rules like this. This is rule set name. We can define anything here. Export to P8S. And same thing rules, we can create a give the name. Same thing, and create a function over here like this. So after doing this, we need to add the XML libraries from here. I will show you. And after that we need to save and publish rule set. You can see it is showing three fields over here. Similarly, I have created for the export to XML and export to P8. I have given the custom name here. Now I will explain first to export to XML. Now first thing what we need to do, I have created here four rule set. First for open XML file, then export electricity XML, then export hotel XML, then close XML. Now open field there is a function Now this is the function. First function is it will give the export path for the where this function will export the XML file. What is the name of this? Is a batch ID. At the rate of batch ID means it will take the current batch ID. Now after that it is a XML new node. It will show the infratel batch ID plus at the rate batch ID. It means it will show the tag infratel under that batch ID underscore current batch ID number. So you can check the hierarchy over here where we this is tag, where is the tag in the XML library. You can see this is tags are available, new node, similarly set XML file, just click in set export path, it is given here. After doing the open XML, we need to create the multiple tags and values based on the field defined in the DCO. See, this is a function electricity XML. Function is export XML. You can use custom name is there. So new node, this means electricity bill is the tag name, and it will come under the infratel because infratel is already defined here. And now it is showing new node name is at the rate ID and electricity bill. That means it will contains all the tag for the lower version. Like here we are creating the tag name as well as the values. Now it will give the new node name is customer name. This is name of the customer, tag customer name. And at the rate ID means it will give the value over here. And we have created the node name node, and after that we need to set the value in this field. So it is showing the customer name is the tag name as well as customer name is our field value. I will show you. See, first one is the tag name and second was the value. At the rate p slash customer underscore name means it is will give the value here. So we need to do the two steps over here. First creating the node and set the value like this. This is the second one, customer address. It is a tag name, and at the rate ID means it will come under the electricity bill because we are creating the multiple tags under the electricity bill. Right, so here I am setting the XML node value to customer address to at the rate says customer. This is mapped to this customer address. Second one is here and first one is the tag name. So creating this similarly multiple lines for all the fields available here, and similarly we will create the same for the hotel bill. You can see here, this is hotel bill will come under infratel, and same node name ID contains the hotel bill tag. Here we will create a multiple tags under the hotel bill. This is the first one is hotel name, and set value here, set value hotel name at the rate hotel name. First one is the tag name and second one is the second one, this one, this values contain this hotel name. So we are defining like this all these fields. Now after that we need to close the XML file. So just XML underscore save file is we have picked from this export XML, you can see. And if you want to see any detail regarding the tape, so just select this XML underscore save file and here display. It will give the information of this tag, what this function will do. Similarly we can check all the method available here, and we can check the details. right? Now we have created this XML file. Now we will create a new rule. Similarly, we will create a new rule set for export to P8. So here it is contain three rules. First, login, we will create a connection, then upload the electricity bill, then upload the hotel bill. Now login portion, we have to set the URI WSRI support. So you can check here, it provides the library for the FileNet P8, this one, and here multiple functions are already available, so we need to just pick and set it. You can, if you will select it and just open it, it will show the details how to use this tag, right? Now after that, login, it is username password for the login, and after that you need to set the locale. Now set the target class ID. It is a object store you are using here, object store. And name of the object store, set target object ID is a name of the object store over here. This is target OS, right? Because we are using here case manager, so I am using the target object store for connecting it. Okay. Now, after that, login. This is a hotel bill. This is upload hotel bill function is there. So first, set doc ID. We need to set the name of the document, hotel bill. We can set the document title over here like this. You can see function is available here. Set destination folder where this document will be filed. Now we can set the property. Now this first one is a hotel name, is the name of the document class property. Here we are doing the mapping within the data cap property and the document class properties. So this one is the hotel, second hotel underscore name is the this field is there. So we are transferring value to here. Similarly, setting the set property arriving date and arrive underscore date. So we are setting here five properties and then upload. Finally, it will upload in the FileNet with five properties. Now, after that, we can set for the electricity bill. This is name of the document class is infra underscore electricity bill. Because we are launching solution in the case manager, so it is showing an infra word is a keyword for the character for the solution. It is showing infra underscore everywhere. I will show you the same thing in the case manager. But we need to set the folder over case manager folder where under the document is case structure where document we are creating the document folder in the solution. I will show in the solution later on. And similarly, we can set the document title, set property for all the customer name. This is infra underscore customer name is a document class name, document class property name, and this is the customer name is the data cap property. Similarly, we have to create the 15 properties over here, and next FileNet upload. It will upload all the content as well as metadata into FileNet. Now after that, we can create the TIFF file into PDF, export into PDF itself. So this is a global function. How to use it? You can see this is global rule set here, and here is already function is there, create TIFF for PDF. Just right click and click on the install in application. So when you will click over here, it will come over here. This like this. When you will open it, it will show like this, and you can set RR set electricity bill. You can set the author, you can set the subject, you can set the keys, and you can set the PDF producer. Everything you can set here. Now it this document will convert TIFF to the PDF. Now after this, achha, this is not in use. I'm just deleting it. So first we need to lock it. Remove. Yes. Okay. Now after that, for mobile it is for the mobile version. So we need to create two rule set for the mobile. First one, set DPI here. Here we will set the DPI. See, this set image DPI by width. So I have configured here the DPI itself, 192 DPI with the width 8.27, and another rule is convert has a two rule set. First is R convert, second one is the R convert fixed patch close. Now in the convert we have used the OCR A convert image to BW to JIO, because it is, we are doing this thing because from the mobile application JPG files are coming. So what data cap is doing, it is converting JPG file to the TIFF file internally. So we required this two methods, and R convert fixed patch close, we need to use three version here, three function here. Copy or origin to children, remove source images, rename TIFFs to standard. So this thing is only required for the mobile application, nothing required. So now we have created the rule set here. Now we need to configure this rule set to DCO. This is here, DCO means here, this is DCO test 21, right? And also we need to define all those things here in the task profile. So I am showing you how to check it. First I am showing you export to XML. You can see, select this one and now click on the sync button. It will show, it is showing here export to XML. This is open XML. We need to define as the batch level, because this is a batch name and this is a batch level name is showing here. Now after that, next rule is export electricity. It is showing on the page level because it will create the XML file when this type of document page will be getting, right? Now same export hotel ML XML is defined on the page level. Okay. Now closing of this thing, closing the XML will be done by at the batch level, is the closing tab. These are two tabs are available for open and closing. Right. Now this is export to XML, and next one is export to PET. Again login will done at the batch level. You can see here batch level, and upload function will be called at the page level, because this will work as per the pages. It will get the invoice, electricity invoice, then this rule will run, or if it will get the hotel invoice, then this hotel rules will run, right? So it depend on the which type of template we are getting. I am I have taken two template over here because it will be more clear. So we have configured the two rules. Now we need to configure this, because it is a global method, so it will convert automatically here. So no need to add into DCO itself. Similarly, recognize page in field, it is a global rule, so no need to define into DCO, right? And now we will configure this convert method for the mobile. I will show you. Yep, rconvert. This is defined in the. We need to add the DCO into the at the others pages. And second one, second F convert R convert fix batch to close at the close level. Now I will show you how to add the rules in the DCO. Suppose this is a convert R convert fix batch close. I want to add at the opening the batch. So just first lock it and then select it, and after that just click on add to DCO. You can see that it is added here. So we need to add all the rules like this. Just select where we want to add and click on the add to DCO. Don't forget to lock this DCO first. Now I am removing deleting it. Okay, now after that changes, just save and unlock it. Okay, now we have added all rules to the DCO. Now we need to add this all rules in the task profile itself. This is the page ID, and here it is a image enhancement, identify pages, create document, document triggered. It is a default one. In the profiler you can see set API. We have custom rules, convert is custom rules, and recognize pages and filter default one. So how to add this to one here? Just log the task profile and select the profiler, and again select the convert which we want to add. Then add rule set to profile. See, convert is again added here. Similarly, like set DPI, select it and add to profiler. Now you can change the order like this here, again like this. You can set here which one, which should be executed first. Now I'm deleting it. Okay. Similarly, we need to add in the export to XML and export to PET. Just select this one and click on add to DCO. See. Okay. Now removing it. After that, save and unlock it. Now in this first part, we have created first the document, then pages, then fields, right? After that we have created the rules, and we have added some recognized pages and fields, multiple fields, right? And added export to XML rule set, export to PET rule set, create TIFF or PDF, set DPI and convert for the mobile. And after that we have added all those things in the DCO as well as task profiler. This is the end of the first part, and second part we will discuss what is the repository configuration in the navigator, desktop configuration for navigator, and configuration required for navigator task using DataCap administrator.